And they're just not going to worry about it this tournament, I don't think.
They also lost to OG's Drow earlier in this tournament as well. I think that they'll probably ban the Naga again because they've been doing that pretty much consistently versus OG. So I think the Naga and the Coddle. The Coddle seemed a little bit like out of it. I mean, I know OG plays it, but, you know, it's like...
A first ban hero. First ban. You really want to use it, yeah.
I have a question here. Now, it's obvious that OG, like many teams facing EG, are going to be banning out the Wisp. We used to know OG to be a big Wisp team themselves, but since then, they don't have crit anymore, and obviously no Tails not playing support. Is this team still would consider going for Wisp? Would you put Jerix or Fly? I've seen Fly play Wisp a little bit, but... I don't know. Is this team the same Wisp team that they were before?
I would say not.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, you want Jerix on one of the heroes that does more than a Wisp alone. You want him to be able to do more early game, and Wisp sure can help out early game, but is not as cannot be as dominant as he can be on other heroes. And Fly, I think he sacrifices a lot of his farm for his teammates, which is, you know, what you should do in the 5 position. And Io, he's just needs a little bit more than that.
I agree. I think it's like, as much as you want them to, because they have No-Tail, and he probably can command the Wisp to kind of do what he would want him to do, it's like, you know, you definitely want Jerix or Fly to be playing something a bit different.
But where they don't have a Wisp is where they now have the best Ursphere player on the planet, though. Yep. So you do trade out, like, one specialist for another there. And OG is, like, one of those only teams where you may still have to respect ban that Ursphere just so they don't get it. Right off the bat, OG, without hesitation, just first pick Naga. Typically, it'd be a thorn in the side for EG.
The one time they don't ban it out.
The one time, yeah. I mean, I kind of assumed that they'd grab it right away. EG banning the bat, though. I mean, it's safe bans. You know, the bat, the drought. Yeah. They lost to both of those heroes versus OG previously, so it's not too much of a shocker to see them remove both.
Something's got to get through.
Do you think they banned the bat because they thought they could get their hands on the Warlock? Because so far, Warlock has been mostly picked first and not banned that often in the first phase.
Maybe, but I. Who would OG have banned instead themselves?
Maybe Ogre?
Naga?
Maybe, Ogre. Maybe.
I think they're fine, like, because they know EG has been first picking Ogre, and Ogre's not really the best, like, first pick hero in the game, so I think they're fine giving away an Ogre first pick. It is kind of crazy, EG giving up the Naga. I mean, they play versus NP a lot, and that hero's, though, one of the few heroes that NP beats EG with.
And No-Tail is not a joke on the hero.
He is not.
A micro lord, and has been for throughout his Dota / Haunt career, so...
He's been playing it in pubs pretty much every game too. Yeah, like every other game.
It's your plus MMR hero.
Yeah, he's trying. He's not winning all of them, but he's trying.
11 losses in a row or something he had the other day.
He did have 11 losses.
Could potentially now be showing both of their cores. Now, obviously, there is an option for a Naga support, but OG not afraid to really kind of show their hand at the first phase.
Quite an interesting opener for sure. Yeah, Naga and Juggernaut together. They don't really have, like, I guess, massive synergy. I guess sleep with Healing Ward and stuff to reset, but.
Yeah, like how they pick two cores and EG picks like the most basic like support hero. There's like Ogre.
Have you ever
doesn't give away anything.
Have you ever seen Jug's face? Is he ugly?
No.
I thought he was in like one of the Dota 2.
I thought he was
in. Videos.
I thought he is. Look, was a troll type, but I'm not sure.
It's probably hideous under there.
There's
sure.
probably some lore in there. Oh yeah, he is probably hideous. That's why he wears a mask.
Yep. Speaking of hideous, we got Venomancer. It's the second pick for EG. It's an EG staple now. Is it going to be jungle? Is it going to be core? Is it going to be Zai hiding in the side shop for first blood? Now we don't know.
Yep. It seems they've been, I think only Zai's played this tournament, right? I believe they haven't played it carry, unless they did the first day.
Wings had a really nice answer to the Venomancer.
Yep.
Trajan Protector.
The one punch hero there.
Yes.
The one punch man.
Invisibility first. Oh,
is it
man.
Something that OG might go for? Is it not? It's not really their type of hero, but you know, you've seen it work.
I mean, you have support option for a support Naga who could kind of do a little bit of the same, get in there, weasel a bit.
I don't think you want to pick like an insane amount of melee versus a Veno.
Yeah. And you already have two of your cores.
Yeah, I think they already have two cores. But, it's still the Naga always leaves stuff open, I guess, for a bit. But EG banning out the Coddle, that's very expected once the Naga's shown.
I could see OG go for, like, back for a Rubick or something. They've gone it a couple of times. You get that natural null field to help against all the magical damage. Plus, you get some good stealing options. You can just take the Venom Wards for yourself, or maybe his ulti. At Bloodlust, let's say. I've seen OG pick it out a couple of times. Fly's not afraid to play it. Or Jerix, they're both pretty good at Rubick.
I think they're also going to be banning out just the Naga, you know, the Naga matchups. It looks like, I'm assuming it's probably going to be a core Naga just because they banned the AM. You know, they want to have the Naga be able to scale into a harder potential of compared to an anti-mage. So the next one will probably be another hero that scales super well versus the Naga.
Like,
Morphling, or I think Morphling's probably the most more likely one.
We have not seen much EG Terrorblade either. There's a Morphling going to go. I mean, what else is left EG to face off against a Naga that we've seen EG pull out? Occasionally, you know.
Sven is okay, but obviously, you know, it's not the most ideal. Mm-hmm. But you do benefit from Bloodlust.
Might see the Timbersaw come out as well.
Mm-hmm.
Quick work of those illusions.
Bloodlust to Timbersaw, you know, NP, we're big fans of that one.
Oh, yeah, I remember Mojo specifically saying he was a huge fan of that.
The Bloodlust to Timbersaw, you know.
EG ban out that Earth Spirit. Just got to give respect where it's due. Wherever the hero lies in this meta, Jerix will find a way to make him seem like still an OP kind of a hero.
Yep.
He just does things that I don't see any other Earth Spirit do. He'll attempt the non-Agnums, roll into base, kick him out, just straight up kick him right out.
It's crazy.
Like, no one goes for those kind of ballsy moves, but he's so comfortable doing it. And, okay, third pick, going to be an Axe for OG.
I was actually thinking about Axe for EG.
Yeah, same here.
And now you give up pretty – I would say you probably gave up three of your cores. I don't believe I've seen OG play support Naga Siren. Doesn't mean they can't.
Yeah, I remember S4 saying he's been – I can't remember what interview it was, but he had been saying that he'd been drilling a lot of Axe.
Yep.
You know, obviously he'd been a mid lane player for a lot of his Dota life, transitioned to the off lane, and did feel comfortable being able to take heroes like Batrider and Axe there. And EG are going to grab that Timbersaw as recommended before.
Shiver's on fire.
Yeah,
call the next two picks here,
Shiver.
I don't want to do anything.
Because she's drinking a monster.
Oh, the rehab.
The raspberry. I didn't have that one before.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
I'm actually nervous.
About raspberries?
No, the tea and lemonade one.
Oh, it's like Arnold Palmer, right?
Well, I'm not a big tea fan, though.
But it's iced tea. Yeah, sweet. It's different than, you know, you're not going
to
heat it up.
You'll just need to put extra sugar, probably, in a gram.
All right.
Because you're just so sweet.
Oh, thank you.
Fourth pick here for OG. It's time to get some supports. Showing everything you got to offer for the mid to late game. Now it's time to see who your foundation is. Who's going to, you know, maybe a Silencer, shut down Timbersaw. What do you think about, like, a Disruptor or something for OG?
I like Disruptor just in general. It gives great vision, great catch. The Silence is great against Crystal Timber. But
what about a Crystal Maiden?
Oh,
my goodness.
I mean, Fly advocates this hero so much.
He loves
the Crystal Maiden. I did like the Disruptor, though, obviously the idea with the Naga Siren, too. And
hello.
Ooh.
Okay.
EG's busting out. We've seen a...
And look at all the Aghanim's upgrades already.
Yeah, everyone.
Is it too late to make some crazy swap around and do what we saw DC try to do and pull out the No-Tail Meepo in the fifth pick or something?
For OG?
Yeah.
Not versus Timber, right?
No way, right? It's I think EG just really covered a lot of their bases pretty nicely with this Alk pick.
That was a very good Alchemist
Alk
pick, for sure.
Alk and Venomancer.
They've had their struggles with and against Alchemist as well.
Yes.
But this is looking like a really decent Alchemist game.
It's a great matchup, like, into Naga, because you can farm just faster. You can get your Radiance timing and everything just much sooner.
And you have a lot of push already with the Venno. Good team fight with Timber.
They don't really have, like, a crazy amount of damage to take care of the Alchemist right now either once he gets, like, an armlet. Like, these heroes take a bit of time. Axe needs a blink. Like, Naga doesn't get online that early. Jug. If it's a mid-Jug, he can lane quite well versus the Alchemist. We've seen, actually, RTZ solo die to a few Juggernauts mid, I want to say.
Yep.
But it's going to be, you know, Sumail, so it's going to be a bit different.
Can they pick something for Ana that is... And have Jerex play Naga Siren instead, and then have something that absolutely dominates Alchemist? Is there anything that absolutely dominates Alchemist mid?
Say Juggernaut's probably the best
Or Timbersaw mid, for that matter, because, you know...
Could be either.
Could be either, yeah.
More than likely the Alchemist, but, yeah. I mean, this Timber short lane is like that's like a Wings thing, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
They just love doing it. I mean, it's super good versus Naga. It's very good versus the Axe. Scales quite heavily.
And doesn't need any help from Ogre Magi or Venomancer in the lane, so they can do whatever they want.
Yeah, we see DC at TI6 did that a lot. Just give Moon, let him do his thing. And
yeah, put him
have
in
fun.
The short lane.
Yeah.
It's going to be interesting here. Is EG thinking about their last and final ban? And
they have a lot of bonus time left.
Yeah, they have plenty of time to be able to think about this. For a brief moment, I thought maybe OG could get like an AA.
Disruptor,
they ban the AA though, and then go right for the Disruptor.
So it is a core Venno.
I think it's always safe to ban AA when you have, you know, like especially just Alchemist, but Timbersaw as well. Like, gets hurt quite a lot.
What about the core Ogre Magi? We've seen EG do it before a very long time ago.
I doubt it. It has to be RTZ.
That's a Tolera root gaming special from back in the day.
Oh,
mid lane
boy.
Ogre. That was awesome. That was like Summit 2 qualifier run. I remember seeing like core Ogre.
Nope.
My Venomancer core, indeed. And there's the Tiny.
And then the Alucard Tiny.
So it's Naga support, right? Yeah, Naga Crystal
More
Maiden.
Or support Tiny, secret style from Frankfurt. They're going to toss the mid lane creep. Here we go. Dirty tactics here. They haven't picked their hero. Okay.
It is.
It's going to be the cheeky Tiny, maybe?
What? Oh, my God. You're right.
You could punish the Alchemist with it. You just take away the wave.
What is happening in this draft already?
I think that Alchemist really... it feels like the Alchemist pick was like... Yeah. Just really a strong pick.
It was really strong pick. Dude, now they at least, you know, Axe doesn't need a blink too early with the support Tiny. You just throw him in there.
Get in there, buddy. No, wait. It's Universe Venno. So they're just completely swapping it up
now.
This
is crazy. Okay. Have we ever seen Universe play the Venno?
Maybe once, if that. This is actually insane.
This is going to be support, a barn burner support as we get underway, folks. Everyone get ready. Relax. Sit down. Put on your favorite bit of Argyle and enjoy with us at the Summit House.
Beautiful.
We will be pushing to release those photos, of course. At the end of the event, we'll get those photos out there for you. I know everybody was really anxious to maybe make it their wallpaper and such, so don't worry.
I want a calendar.
We will hook you up. We wanted to make sure, though, that we got to slowly reveal everything as it went here. So Jarek's indeed on the... Tiny already. Very anxious to see if he is going to be doing any sort of early creep shenanigans.
When Seeker did that, that was on the Radiant side, right?
That was correct. That was with Pile I Die on the Radiant side, but it is just as easily feasible on the Dire side.
I guess, yeah.
Okay. Toss range is what maxed at level 1, so yeah, you can easily toss. I think even that camp right there or the camp north of the mid lane.
Yeah, you can do
tower,
both.
Yeah. Either way, you can definitely toss it. But
there's a scared Tiny.
Oh, he goes right up the hill and
dead.
Right into him. There is no chance at all for Jarex to live here. It was nice knowing you, but he's got to go.
RTZ snatching the kill.
And they're going to block that camp maybe, so he can't do the pull? Oh, I thought maybe.
Yeah, I think they are.
Yeah, they are. There's still one of the camp, but if Jarex goes up there at the start, realizes it's not there.
Camp blocked.
But look at they're already pinging it out.
I mean,
I'm worried for OG, honestly. Like, this Tiny support, it seems like it can be clever and stuff. Maybe they'll be able to pull some, like, nice stuff out of it. But their lineup can't really hit buildings, especially versus EGs. Like, Venom Wards with Acid Spray and everything. None of these heroes can naturally actually just take a building down. They have to win a big team fight in order to really gain any objectives. They don't really have the best Rosh hitter either. It's just, like, a lineup where they want to delay. But I think EG's lineup actually benefits from that.
So Jarek's in the top lane now. I don't know if that whole early debacle kind of dissuade him from doing any sort of... mid lane pull, but for now he'll take it to the top lane where it looks like it's going to be him and Axe. So I guess he gets a free blink dagger. Toss calls.
Yep.
Easy.
And I think EG got the lanes they wanted because they pinged out Pink running up top. They saw the rotation with that ward.
Yeah, Dire sees Venno, it as well. Ogre Magi top.
Universe Venno.
Yeah, I mean it's going to be Timbersaw versus Axe. That's a pretty good matchup.
As well, it looks like Disruptor's going bottom.
Yep.
Definitely something a little bit different here for both teams. Game number one, No Tail already going to get harassed down. Fly is nearby and should be able to help a brother out. Hits him with the slow, and they're going to be forced to crawl back the other way. Jarek's tossing back, boom! Throws the Venomancer right back into the heart of the team.
Oh, the Riptide missed?
Yeah, not nearly enough damage to be able to get the finish. Cheeky little play, but not going to get done.
You can only do that twice before you're out of mana.
Yep.
You have Crystal Maiden, though, so.
You do. That's
You got to get that Arcane Aura online first, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they're splitting experience three ways. It's like No-Tail's like playing like a support, while Jarex is kind of playing like the carry right now or something.
What's
I have no clue what's going on.
They're way away from the lane. They want to give him the XP, too. Like, maybe they just want him to get that toss stun combo faster.
That could be.
That's weird.
It's still very weird, though.
Yeah, he's just single pulling top. He's just playing support Naga with the poor man's shield.
Well.
Middle lane 6-0 for Alchemist. He's doing good. I mean, it should be pretty even early until Acid Spray wears down.
It's a shame that Ana doesn't have the Immortal Juggernaut set that No-Till does have.
You like that set?
Yeah, I like this one. Fancy. I like this one too. It's fine.
Well, this one you can actually clearly see that it's Juggernaut, which for
and
the other
Prince
one you
of
can't.
Persia, yeah.
How many Arcanas does that hero have? I don't know, like 6. It feels like now.
I feel one more and we'll be good.
Well, he is going to get one more.
He is getting one more, right?
Wait, actually?
We still don't have
the because he won the Arcana vote.
Remember everyone was like, no Wisp, give Jug more.
They should have made this set the Arcana, though, because...
Ogre hasted. Ana does not have spin. Skilled? He does have a point save.
He does have mana, though.
Yeah, he has a point save, too. Yeah, Ogre's just going to punch
him. Just going to donk him a little bit.
You're going to need an ID to get in this club.
Boom. I'm out.
Oh.
Just run away.
Down and
he's like, guys, I gotta ward this.
Yeah. I gotta go suicide.
Oh, he's
ward then
himself.
Suicide.
Ward
yeah.
then suicide. Yeah.
I challenge these. One versus. Okay.
Only lost 2 gold.
Got him.
Good value.
This mid lane, though. I mean, he does have a big creep wave coming in, but Sumail's doing a very good job right now.
He missed one last hit.
Yeah, so Ogre goes back top as well. The Venomancer are still there, and
free bounty.
It is still the Tiny that is taking the farm.
Yeah, this is really interesting. I mean, it makes sense. You need to. I mean, Tiny has to have farm. That's why you do the pulling and whatnot. But they're just fully giving it to him.
Naga is a hero that can catch up real well, though. That's great. But in the meantime, nobody's pulling or stacking either. You know, there's this one camp.
I'm very confused.
Yeah, it's just something totally different here for OG.
Probably in about 10 minutes or so, we're going to say, oh my god, that's actually brilliant!
Toss back from Jerix here. It puts the Ogre back in the lane, but as we know, it's an Ogre. And he can take the shots here, but Jerix is getting bombarded with right clicks here from Universe on the back end side with that Poison Sting. He's definitely having a lot of trouble. They might be able to finally get the finish on the Ogre, and they will. OG get themselves on the board here, and we'll even things up.
They took a lot of damage for that.
Yeah.
I have some region left, luckily.
Yeah, this is a scary RTZ. Pretty much free farming as well as the Alchemist right now.
Alco, of course, had the benefit of the Bounty Rune here, so his economy's certainly taken off. Look at his team. Everybody really benefits from an Aghanim Scepter, too, so they have like a, what feels like the highest ceiling for this late game.
What level is Disruptor right now? I think that's a big thing. Still,
he's he's actually only level 1.
I wonder what he's been doing.
I think he tried to, I guess he was trying to really hard zone the Axe, but he should definitely just be pulling in this. Just getting his levels for sure. Yeah, Axe is already level 4. It's actually really good for S4.
I think he stacked some of the camps as well, though.
Yeah, it looks like the
It looks like, okay.
Yeah, so he has been, not that one, the one to the left. That one. No! Okay, well, then I don't know.
I'm not too sure what Crit was actually doing with his time. I mean, he must have just been trying to really focus on zoning him out, but either way.
Kinetic field onto S4, but it's pretty tanky right now. And takes a hard shot right there and opts to run for the river. But they got the glimpse. They pull him on back.
He health potted up, though.
But yeah, he's got enough health back, and with the call, he'll be able to walk away from any trouble.
RT's even ate a mango there. Super value for S4.
Just baiting out of everything.
I think that they're really going to struggle to kill this this Alchemist, though. I mean, he's completely free farming. There's no pressure on him whatsoever. Their heroes don't really take him out that easily, honestly. Like, it's... I don't know. It's definitely a bit scary for OG for me.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to go on Ogre. A lot of armor there, though. Yeah. But here he comes. Should go down.
Gets ensnared. Wants to move in for Fly, though. Hits him with the... they'll just toss him up and down. They'll be the end of the Ogre.
I assume they're giving all the farm to Tiny because he is the one hero maybe they can burst down the Alchemist in the mid game.
Yeah, I guess that's why.
Naga
must be.
Does a little bit of, like... sustained damage, but Tiny still really can burst.
That's a really good point. I think that's actually probably exactly what they're thinking here.
You'll get the Axe and the Tiny, like, online almost at the same time, and you can just definitely make an impact. Enough that you will cause a diversion, probably, and some attention drawn away from the Naga. Shushi can almost be like the insurance policy for OG's late game. So, they're just keep banking on, I would imagine, like a Bash Brother duo between Axe and Tiny.
Yeah.
Because, he doesn't even need a Blink Dagger.
Oh, first smoke gank, and they're going to run into an Axe.
They will. It's 2-on-1, though, and Crit's got Glimpse. He's got Kinetic Field. This is going to be very
Sumail's even here.
Oh, God. He's like, I'll take that money.
Give him the last hit.
He's too far away, but they'll Glimpse him right into the arms,
got
him. And he gets the last hit.
And he's got a Bounty Rune. That's actually Armlet. He has Armlet already at six minutes. Yep.
Probably one of the best Alchemist starts you could ask for already.
Yep.
Sir.
Spiking ahead in that net worth. That's crazy.
That's big, too. You know, they kill the Axe, who's getting very good levels. We mentioned Crit being a little bit underleveled in that lane. Now he's doing just fine. He even has great net worth. And now they even get some tower pressure off of it.
They might actually just get this whole tower kill.
Yeah, they might actually get the whole thing.
The Timber Saw disrupt.
The Bloodlust. Dude, the Bloodlust at Timber Saw.
Look.
He's not even Bloodlusted. Come on, Sai.
Fly shows himself in the lane. The second he does, RTZ tries to go for an opening here, but we'll get hit with the Frostbite and slow down. S4 now by his side. Lots of damage on that tower, but it will stand for now.
Oh, and the Tiny's down there, so they rotated almost everyone.
Oh, yeah.
They need to get something there, otherwise that rotation is going to be...
They gave the Tiny the levels, and now, they're switching it up. So this is cool. This is very interesting.
They definitely want to toss Axe in.
Yep.
Here we go.
There he goes.
Boom! Right onto RTZ with the call.
Hey, should be pretty dead here.
He's done for sure.
Very nicely done.
Very clever.
This is OG's time now. This is... a big power spike, being able to utilize stuff like that. But we'll see if EG it's like, we'll take it once, but then we'll look to avoid that moving forward.
Killing the Tempter is very good, but remember, this Alchemist is... Yeah. He's double net worth already. That's an incredibly good start.
Oh, Zai getting found out again.
Jarek's though, making the plays.
This is Jarek's things, whether it's an Earth Spear, whether it's a Tusk, Bounty Hunter, Tiny. He always seems to make the most at this point in the game.
He's got Crystal Maiden Aura, he's got 9 stick charges, and I think they're looking to make maybe Samil's life a little bit more difficult.
It would just be so hard.
I don't think they can kill him with Raindrop and with Armlet.
Yeah.
It's just way too much sin. He does, even without his ultimate, it's going to be tough to bring him down if he has the armlet on. If he's max HP, of course.
Yeah, they're perfectly fine just...
However, if he just walks into them, though, this could be a bit scary for Sumail.
Yeah. Well, he sees it's blocked, and he's like, uh-oh, something might be going on here.
Yeah, they feel the pressure in their jungle. So I was like, yo, I'll tank the gank. Just check it out up here. The creep dunk to live!
Yep.
He got to do that for the movement speed for sure to get away from the Chakram combo.
Oh, the Night Tower.
They're still eyeballing this mid lane as much as possible. And obviously this is when Naga can just take the top lane, but it is a Naga versus Venom, which is kind of awkward. But you can tell this is when they're running around, trying to make some plays here, trying to create some space. Jarex goes from mid, now back to bottom.
He's on the prowl, though. Let him go.
Yes, he is. And Arteezy's already looking to get far back and away.
I mean, they have a ward right there,
Level 7 is the ideal for Tiny to just be moving around like this, so it's very interesting, you know. It's something that we definitely don't see happen very often, obviously, just because... Tiny's kind of falling out of favor.
We see Universe now. It's a straight up one on one lane. The Nog is going to get dominated by that Venom if he doesn't get help.
Yep. EG knew that there was vision somewhere on their side of the map from OG. They placed 3 sentry wards and they still haven't found that observer that is.
No-Till's cutting the path for Jarex. He needs to cut one more tree.
Was he trying to throw someone up to the tower?
I think he just wants to get the wraparound without having to show himself.
Yeah. Okay, he's getting close. The ward's just south of him. Zai's right there. Hyatt's going. Gets the toss off before the stun can come out from Zai.
Didn't throw him
damage,
back, though.
Yeah, he just instantly went for the direct toss stun combo.
It's just Zai eating all these tiny ganks.
Yeah.
He's just running into him. He's like, whatever, okay. I'll bloodlust you later.
It's like what Jarex did the other day when he was playing Ogre. He just had like 11 deaths or something, but he was like, I'm doing my job, guys.
Yep, just casting level 4 bloodlust. That's all you need. I do want to see if he goes the 1-1-4 building at stats. He said he would.
Crit's been really emphasizing trying to deward their jungle because of that invasion from OG, and I don't know if any of those sentry wards actually caught anything. He put down 3 in his own jungle. So good warding coming out from OG, getting that nice deep ward, and OG Crit not spotting it.
Here comes the smoke from OG now, looking to hustle into EG's base. What are they going to get done here? Nearby is Crit.
Uh-oh.
But they're already making the move for S4.
The S4 bait.
They pop down a war, and they're going to be rushing in. S4 gets glimpsed back, but the fight's coming from OG, and here we go. Jumps right in. Jarek's going to get the toss up and down, looking to go for Zai. Zai and Arteezy caught in the mix right there. There's going to be a Frostbite freeze. He goes for the Timber Chain, makes it to the side job, and hides down south while Fly in a lot of trouble. Jarek's been able to get that finish. Fly makes it out just in time. On is here to play now. Blade Fury, but can't quite get the catch up onto Crit, but the stun will help out. He gets close enough and will get the right click in, but Universe has shown up, drops down the Poison Nova. Ana instantly escapes back to the fountain to make it away safely. 2-for-1 trade.
That was very close to not being a trade at all.
Yep.
That was definitely an awkward approach.
Some pretty bad bounces on the obvious slash. There were a lot of creeps there to go to, but Timbersaw gets away with like 150 HP. It may have been, he could have maybe spawned, but it's like inevitable that the Timber lives. And S4 just dying. If he had like lived another 4 seconds, 3 seconds or something, it would have been a completely different turn up for OG. But nice little rotation there by them to try to keep the pressure on. Like we mentioned, that's kind of what you want to do. But EG did draft this lineup that you have to pressure so many multiple heroes that it makes it very difficult.
So what's Universe do now on his Venomancer? He's away from the offlane, and that's where No-Tail is just going to slowly try to, farm up behind everyone's back.
Yep.
Oh, and there's the Sacred Relic.
Already got Relic.
It's 400 away from... This is super early time. Not super early, but really early.
Courier died.
What?
Is that a dead courier? Did I see that?
No. I think you're crazy.
Yeah, no,
that says courier, dude.
Yeah, it's
the courier's black and white. It's definitely dead.
I didn't even see it die during that engagement. Oops.
Died with a tome.
All ghosts are black and white.
Yep. Oh, and he's trying to chase No-Tail.
Gets it done with the Timber Chain right at the back end of that. Arteezy will take down No-Tail. And on the other side, though, they take a core of their own, run right into Sumail, and blast him down with the combo.
He's got the Radiance, though, at least.
Yeah, it was too late for that.
Still a good kill, but yeah, he didn't lose anything.
I don't think he was full HP at all, because that combo shouldn't really burst him down like that. But still, it was a very good rotation by OG. That ward that they got earlier, the deep ward, is actually paying off so much now.
He already got that Radiance, but I mean, look at Alk's net worth. You're definitely going to get a little bit of value net worth from that. But Crit going to be caught right behind the tower. Flying Jerix again. Able to get it done, and now we have Blink
on Tiny.
Not just on S4, but on Tiny as well.
Jerix is making the plays.
This is like the best form right now. Like, this is where you got to do the most of your work, especially as this four man. So this guy right here, No Tail, could, you know, pull into the late game just in case. He's going to take bottom now. He doesn't want to be caught up top.
Like, oh, this could be the big fight.
They don't have their Blinks on them yet. It's coming out on the Courier. This is going to be... This is definitely scary for OG here.
If they can make it to the high ground, they'll be in a great position. Only S4 is heading that way, and he's already been spotted by one ward. Jerix spots out and almost takes out Sumail, but he is going to be able to get the ultimate off and now starts regenning all that health right back. He's able to get off the stun. Jerix goes down. And it's a bit frantic here for OG. Universe dishes out a nice poison Nova, and then they make their move, looking for the better target. And Ana chases on from Arteezy, slows him down, and he goes right for the Omni Slash to stay alive, but he's still caught between three. Goes for the Blade Fury, tries to make it back in a way, buys his Yasha, block out from the ward. Eventually, they will bring him down. Three
gold.
For one trade.
There you go. Yeah, they. Sumail did not have his raindrop on him there, so he actually almost got bursted instantly from the combo.
No.
But yeah, they get three. Nice little smoke play from EG wrapping around. Perfect timing.
Damn, they would have killed that Shaken that was flying in with both Blinks on it.
Yeah.
That actually could have been super game-changing.
Yeah. But OG already, this is the time where they should be getting ahead, right? Where they should be creating space for the Naga Siren. Is losing a fight enough? Even if Naga Siren can farm during that time, is that still worth having a fight like that? Because I feel like they should be ahead at this point, and they're not.
It's hard to be ahead, especially when the Alchemist had free farm middle.
They have time, though. Tier 1's slowly going down. OG still have Tier 2's to fall back on.
Uh-oh, bottom lane. Universe is looking for trouble.
Goodbye, Universe.
Here comes our Blink action. Bada-bing, bada-boom with a dunk! Those are the Bash Brothers, and they get a dunk.
So we're going to see everybody pick up a hood on the side of EG. Yep. At least Tiny, I believe.
Absolutely.
It's very satisfying to watch, though.
Yep.
Dunks.
Yeah.
I like it. I approve.
No Tail getting... Getting some space, but definitely not where you want to be as a Naga versus an Alchemist who almost has triple your net worth. And you're versus a Timbersaw who's just a natural Great Illusion clear and just good throughout all stages of the game, while also Disruptor is also quite good versus Naga to catch him out.
Definitely the case here. And Arteezy, who is second in net worth right now, sports a good chunk of change.
The one nice thing for OG is that they have a clear-cut initiator.
Whoa. Yeah, they do, and here comes another gank. Is it just Zai? They don't want to just get Zai. Sumail would be great.
Sumail would be amazing.
And they see him. They're like, oh, perfect.
Good ward vision.
Rushing all the way up and over here. He's trying to go for some stacks. You do have Crit nearby, but do OG have enough power to get it done right away?
They should be able to.
Jump in. There's going to be the toss combo. Sumail still lives. Stackstorm is going to be committed from Crit. Sumail's not going to be able to get out. He goes down right away. They will be able to get off S4. Here comes the rain from above coming out from Fly. Turns into a 2-for-2 trade. And now EG looking to pick up the rest here as they have infiltrated plenty enough. Looks like they will be able to get Fly down. Crit, though, trying to run away from Ana. Ana says, I've done enough here. We'll TP back and away.
That's good, though. Killing the Alk always gives a huge influx of money because of how high in the net worth he is. But they did lose 3-for-2, and Arteezy was kind of just farming during all that. Not sure actually where he was, though, because he had some port back to base. So I guess he just burned his mana pool pressuring lanes.
And, of course, No Tail farming, too. This is all OG with their four-man. And No Tail's able to get a little bit closer towards that sacred relic here. So
that was, yeah. It's. I mean, it's not like terrible for EG, but it's definitely good for OG to like make the space for the Naga. So it's like it's fairly even. Like it could have been really disastrous if Crit got that static storm off like a 0.1 second earlier or something. Like he was super fast with his reaction already. But yeah, it could have been a pretty scary fight for OG there because of the positioning. And but they didn't take the ancients, so at least Alchemist is able to kind of farm that up once he finds the time to.
Vanguard in order here for S4, it looks like, as he has that ring up. What do you get next for Jerix now that he's hoping to bring in some kills with the help of this Blink Dagger? I mean...
Maybe a Shadow Blade, I think, is
Shadow
usually
Blade.
Helps
usually the pickup,
yeah.
Right? Yeah.
Don't really go straight to Agnum's, not without a Wisp and stuff.
I think that builds... With like the bringing in of Echo Saber and stuff, too, like that Agnum's build kind of like fallen a little bit out of favor.
Yeah.
But Juggernaut, I mean, Anna did a good job of... Yasha almost did a Fusel Blade.
Yeah.
caught up. There's a decent chunk of damage, but now they do have the Bloodstone as well as the Hood on Arteezy. He's super farmed.
Yeah, he's happy to push things back in behind the tower while the rest of his team looks to clear it out here. Ana hiding under darkness right now, but they're looking to burst around top of him. Now Static Storm. He's silenced in place, and eventually he'll die.
That was awkward.
Waiting and hiding in the shadows, and EG happy to just draw him out and take him apart. And the chase ain't done yet. They found Fly. They're jumping right in for him. They'll glimpse him right back to the side shop, and he's hoping that this is his chance to make an escape, but he cannot hide under that shadow amulet. He will go down too, and quickly EG claim the lives of Dose.
Yeah, when you look at Benno, Benno going to be picking up a Hood. I think they're all going to just grab Hoods, basically.
Yeah, it's the smartest idea. Now he's going to take a free tier 2 as well.
I don't know. It's not really feeling like OG have been able to do enough with their 2 blink ass beaters, you know?
Yeah,
it's
like, I agree.
It's like they're trying to. They're making the moves. They're trying like all over the place, but it doesn't feel like it's enough right now, especially versus like this Alchemist and
the two
this Timber.
Fours, yeah, exactly.
Look at this Alk. Like 15 years, double the net worth. I mean, he's definitely like ahead of where he wants to be as an Alchemist.
And he's not even just double ahead. I mean, their safe lane core is second place.
I mean, he's almost level 16 too. Yeah. Like he's level 16 at almost 20 minutes. Like that's gonna be very difficult to bring him down.
The Naga needs a lot more time to try.
How much more is she gonna need before she can do like that split install?
She's got 4K gold.
Yeah, you need to have your Radiance and a Boots of Travel. I would imagine at least.
The thing that's really hard is that even when he has this Radiance and stuff, like Timber Saw is great at clearing the illusions. Disruptor can always glimpse one to clear it out. Alchemist can even clear them out. While OG on the other side, what's this? Oh, this is a big steal for S4, actually.
Yeah, it is. Well, eventually crits here. He gets the Thunderstrike, which means he has the power to glimpse him back. So OG might need to come to help him. Flies on the low ground, but not going to be able to assist. It looks like they will punish S4 for it. He maybe breaks out even with the take of the stack, but they found Fly too, and they will glimpse him back in and take that kill on top of it, and it's going to be Sumail who takes both of them too.
Not worth it.
Not worth it all at that point. He'll finish out the stack too.
So yeah, like I was talking about, like they don't really have anything to kill these Alchemist illusions. So once he's able to do like the split push, it's going to be really hard for OG to really deal with it and find this real Alchemist.
Top lane.
And Jerks goes right for the blink.
Tower.
Oh,
nice.
I see a DC logo there? What was that?
Yeah, they were doing it yesterday, too.
Yeah,
they got all 5 trading cards. You just gotta get it.
Oh, is that what happens when you have the trading cards?
Yeah, you get the teleport effects. Like, where you land, there's like a burned logo of the team.
Well, Jerks is still just chilling in here.
No other OG members in the area, though, so more, I imagine, just for scouting and intel. No tail close to the Radiance here. It's obviously late even for your normal Naga game, but we have to remember looking back, he started almost as like a pseudo-support Naga, just doing single pulls, so he had to wait what felt like until the Blink Daggers came on, then he had the space. So Jerks will keep the push from the top lane subsided, and back to the grind here for OG. But
yeah, I think OG's strategy worked how they wanted to. The only problem is they didn't get the right kills. Like they actually just kept killing the Ogre over and over with the ganks, which really hurt him.
Yeah. Sumail got like the perfect start too. He got like all the bounty runes. He gets a nice little pickup kill as well. Like, when you get a 6-minute armlet on Alchemist, everything's just going your way, honestly. But yeah, OG is definitely trying to make the moves as much as possible, and they've been decently successful, but just not quite enough just yet.
Arteezy's close, but
they're all super easy, though.
Yeah, none of these are easy. They take the high ground, but
Radiant just scanned right behind it, right behind where OG was. So
now they smoked up themselves.
It's just like it's so hard. Like OG's trying to make these plays constantly, but it's like EG's either ready for them or they don't lose enough. Like they don't. They even got the pipe now on Universe, which is going to nullify a lot of the damage coming out.
Yep.
And yeah, Sumail almost has Octarine, and he's about to be 16, like we were mentioning.
OG in the neighborhood.
Oh, Yotail spotted.
Out from the trees. Bolting. They'll clip him back and into a Static Storm. This man is not going to be able to get out the song. He will be taken apart.
He like ran into the trees. He saw him. Like it was like the slowest reaction. He's like, "Oh, that was a real Naga. Okay, just chilling in there."
Fortunately, Naga not able to get a song off or anything the second he was spotted.
16 Bloodstone charges now.
Weesh. It's a very heavy-handed advantage right now for EG. Pressure on OG to kind of make a response play. Oh, he thought about going for the Omni, but jumps back the other way. And they glimpse him under a kinetic field. Obviously, no Stack Storm for this one, but Arteezy comes into the cage and wants to duke it out, but on him will be. Bottom lane. Ooh, combo onto Sumail, and they
he dies, though.
Nice finish right there. Sumail might pay the price for it. Arteezy shows up to play. And he's looking at his play.
Oh, nice. Sick toss.
Nice timing with the toss. Prevents the Timber Chain out, and he makes it out safely. Wonderful play from Jerix.
Ooh, that was
clutch.
They didn't even have the blade mail yet on the axe to kill him.
Yeah.
I don't know if, I mean, don't know what really actually ended up happening.
It didn't look like he
arma
toggled down there.
I think he double tapped it.
Did he? Oh,
I think so he may have double tapped.
Yeah, he might have.
They missed the dunk, but yeah, definitely a great gank for OG, but
that's a lot of money to take down Sumail. Yep. Who got the last hit on that Sumail kill too? Was it Jerix with his combo?
Yeah, Jerix got it.
So what does he get from that? Is it Shadow Blade?
That's why he got to hit that attack speed for the last attack.
Yep.
All right. Wow. All right, OG holding on here.
Yeah.
Still EG's game, but they're hoping, man. They're hoping they can get that Naga farmed up, and they're hoping that they can split push and prevent EG from closing things out.
Yeah, they're trying.
They're certainly trying.
Yep, I think Tiny just goes a straight Silver Edge, right, and tries to combo on the Timber Saw. Like, just do the combo and then Silver Edge hit him. Is that the best chance they have?
To kill
the Timber Saw.
To kill the Timber Saw, yeah.
I think you have to
react
Silver
armor?
Edge, yeah, and just the overall damage.
He's getting to be at that super tanky point, though, because with that hood as well, like, he... He pretty much has almost the same effect of HP or more than Sumail because of that.
Yeah.
Well, this is gonna be a long game if OG manages to pull this one out.
Yeah.
And we talked about that before the game even started, how both teams like to have, you know, some late game insurance.
Oh, well, definitely.
They got it. And they're gonna need it too.
Well, I mean, Alk is certainly got a high ceiling for himself. Getting closer and closer to maxing out his item slots here, but as I said before, their whole team can benefit from Magnum Scepters, all of them.
Yeah.
I don't even know who you give priority first to.
Disruptor?
Yeah, Raptor's ultimate is very good.
Yeah,
don't have to worry about too many BKBs right now, though.
I think probably the Timber, right?
Just
give the Timber, then the Ogre.
Insane damage, yeah.
Like, Ogre gets in the absolutely ridiculous
with Venomancer,
with
you know? It's poison, though. It's good, too.
It's okay.
Anna could be in a little bit of trouble here.
No, he gets popped.
He's dead for sure. They even drop the Static Storm, and they'll gladly take those stacks.
That's Roche. If they want
they've got their item timings. Sumail's got pretty much everything. He's got Octarine now, too, so
all
he's got pretty much all you need.
Yeah.
Aghanims will be starting to come out in the next 5 minutes or so, probably less than that.
How is OG's high ground defense? How well can they defend?
It's all about their sleep.
It's about this. I mean, we've not seen a sleep right now. No sleep yet.
She almost dropped on bottom, but didn't.
I don't know how much faith I put in their high ground defense, to be honest with you.
It's not great.
Not very good. They have the illusions, of course, with the Radiance to spam up, but like we mentioned, like, EG actually has the solutions a bit for that.
Maybe Jerix goes for a blink toss into base or something.
Crazy.
It's like a pudge kind of.
It is a Jerix type of play
as
well.
That's a Jerix play, and I could see him going for stuff like that, but they're hoping to not be stuck in that kind of situation yet. Still pushing out these lanes so that EG can't easily segue into a high ground push.
No-Tail has passed Anna for the first time in this game in net worth.
They need that. They need it to be a little quick.
Yeah, he's crawling up there, but it still takes time. He's got that base Naga build right now with
they
the boots of travel and with the Radiance. Yeah. Now he has Jeb.
That's a map control. He's still level 12, though. If you want to use that song for a decent high ground defense, he won't be level 16.
Yeah, man, he's only level 12.
Yeah.
I mean, that kind of happens with Naga, though, right?
Yeah, you get farm from your illusions, but you don't really get the levels from that, so you gotta... Yeah. You gotta find that elsewhere.
What about for this guy right here? S4. I mean, some may say that the axe in this game might have already passed his prime, but he's got a blink, he's got a blade mail. It's 1,300 gold, so what do you save for at this point? Do you just go more utility to try to help your team out? The Axe's significance come and gone a little bit, but he's got to find a way to make himself relevant in this game.
They're just CGing. They have the pipe. They've had the pipe on Venom for a bit. I don't even think they've used it yet.
I don't think so.
They're just doing this nice and slow. Different from what we saw in the first few days from.
Yeah, their lanes are in good possession, decent spots. Actually, now they're pretty bad, but they have Sentry Wards placed down for the wraparound from the Tiny already.
You know, Naga can't take your stuff that quick.
Yeah.
So you're fine losing a tier 2, maybe.
We said it, like, they don't have good building hitters on the side of OG. Well, EG, once they get online like this, you know, Alchemist just kind of do Alchemist things.
Toss back from Jerix to get Sumail a bit deeper, but EG not afraid to kind of make chase. Arteezy will go in right away, gets rooted down in his spot, and there's going to be our first song of the game. What can OG make out of it?
Is he going to die to Radiance?
Yeah, he gets dropped. Jerix is out, does have a buyback if he feels necessary, and does opt to go for it here. OG knowing that this is a very valued defense that they need to pull out. Sumail still holding on strong, just regenning all that life back very easily here. And EG get right back to the grindstone of taking out these racks, one being chopped apart. What does OG have left in the tank to try to stop him? It doesn't look like too much, and this should be a first racks for EG.
The cores are too tanky. They're just frontlining, and there's nothing they can really do to get past them. It's like this Naga's just too far behind. They just don't have anything else from there. Like, they're just, they lack the damage to actually bring down anybody in a real team fight. They can maybe burst down one target, but killing anybody else is definitely out of the question.
Yeah, I think they just run down another lane. They have an assault Kiris on Sumail now coming out, too.
Oh, he bought the AC?
Yeah, he bought the AC.
So that's just a
just
tower push.
Buildings, yeah.
We still got the Aegis as well. Tiny had to buy back for that fight, and he couldn't even do anything after that. Yeah. Like,
he replaced his armlet already. Oh, no, okay. He put a base.
Yeah. Probably wait for the Aegis, yeah.
Yeah, Arteezy went for the Shivas, so he decided, yeah, to go for the AC.
My goodness.
I feel like OG needs at least another 15 minutes, if they want to have a chance to defend their high ground like that, but...
Is it even good to, like, if they go that length? Okay, Alchemist is six-slotted, but like we mentioned, so every single hero benefits from Aghanim's.
I mean, it's still going to be difficult, but at least then they have some tools to do something, because as you just mentioned, they can't
they
do anything.
Right
they
now.
Can't kill anybody. Everybody's there to back up everybody else. We knew that Jerix was going to try to go for a toss. They toss the Alchemist back. In comes everybody else. What are you going to do? You can't kill that Alchemist anymore.
They don't even have sleep up now because he's not level 16.
These two beefy frontliners with Venom Wards just defending the supports in the back. It's like impossible for them to take out the Ogre and the Disruptor. And yeah, they just... They're going to probably be able to lose this racks, but they're going to go for the big smoke play. They need to do it. They need to get something big off of it.
It's do or die, and if that means you got to go for a complexity wraparound, you will do it. Ana right on front confidently, and they're looking to burst him down, and he can't get off the Omni, so he gets stack stormed and taken apart. He's out. 60 seconds, no buyback. They've spotted Fly 2. He goes for a Glimmer Cape to try to make it back in the way while everyone else crawls inside the base. Arteezy happy to hop up over the fence to get inside. Glimps back now for No Tail. He's got to be forced to go for a song. He gets stunned up in place, frantically looking to go for a TP. We'll be able to make it out. If they get to the fountain, they could glimpse him back in his spot, but nonetheless, they will be able to shred apart what looks like the remnants of S4. Fly, desperate, looking to go for a freezing field. Could get the finish on Sumail's first life, but is that going to be good enough? The rest of EG, very weak and wounded, are going to be forced to run back and away. Dunk comes out from S4, gets one, looking to go for two, gets it done. Double duck for S4. Back inside Arteezy. He could be dropped as well, and he will. OG getting a lot here for their high ground hold, but Sumail's back with his second life and should be able to chop up and finish up S4, and he goes right back for the racks because OG have lost everybody.
Yeah, instant respawn from Arteezy too. But yeah, it's definitely GG. That was a really nice freezing field
that
though by CM.
That was amazing.
Yeah.
Fly actually had... I clicked that fight recap. I want to see how much damage it did. Come on, weapons.
CM
he lost weapons.
Goals.
No, I mean, that was a nice little effort that they tried, but I think inevitably... Their lineup was very hard to play versus this Alchemist Timber, so I think that this Alka pick completely screwed them.
Yeah, we're talking about like the fourth picks. Like when Eon picked that Husker, you just like knew like, wow, this is gonna be a great game for him. Like when we saw the Alchemist pick, we're like, wow, that's gonna be a great game for him, and it was.
Yeah,
gotta applaud OG. I mean, they tried to do the
it was clever
the tiny play where they just bum rush farm onto Jerry.